This is an oscilloscope, and so is this, and so is this. And this is probably what you'll meet in a school. Rather than having a class set all of the same model, you could find yourself with several different varieties of oscilloscopes. This is the kind of trace we'd like to see in an oscilloscope. In this case, the oscilloscope's connected to a signal generator. How did we get a trace like that though? When you switch the oscilloscope on, don't expect to see anything on the screen immediately. In some cases, the oscilloscope takes time to warm up. If you're lucky, after a short time, you should see something like this. Or perhaps like this. If you don't see anything, there are certain things you can do. And to see what they are, we need to know what some of the oscilloscope controls are. Not all oscilloscopes have a trig level control, trig standing for trigger, but if they do, check that it's set to auto when you first use the oscilloscope. On oscilloscopes, this direction here is known as the X direction, and this is the Y direction. It's a bit like coordinates in maths. If you can't see anything on the screen, look for controls marked Y shift or Y position and adjust these to see if you can bring the trace, that's the picture on the screen, into view. Sometimes the X position or X shift control has to be adjusted as well. In this case, you can't see the picture on the screen because the intensity or brightness hasn't been turned up enough. Don't turn it up too brightly though. And usually beside the intensity or brightness control, or close to it, there's a focus control. Let's remind ourselves of what these controls do again. Here's the Y position. Here's intensity or brightness. Here's focus. And here's X position. Try to get a trace like this, or like this, before you connect anything to your oscilloscope. Most school signal generators and power supplies have 4mm sockets. Some oscilloscopes have BNC sockets. So I'm going to use a lead that has a BNC socket at one end for my oscilloscope and 4mm plugs at the other for my signal generator. One of my plugs is color-coded black, and I'm going to make sure that I plug that into the black socket on my signal generator. We're now going to look at two very important oscilloscope controls. First one is called the Y amplifier or the Y gain control. Sometimes though it's just marked volts per division or V/div or V/cm or something similar. Watch what happens when I adjust that. If you come to your oscilloscope and the trace looks like this, turn the Y gain control clockwise until the trace just about fills the screen. On the other hand, if the trace is off the screen, turn it anti-clockwise until the trace is a suitable height. Here's another important control. It's called the time base. Sometimes it's just marked as time/centimeters or time/div. If your trace looks like this, then you need to adjust the time base control. In this case, I need to turn it anti-clockwise. If the trace looks like this, I need to adjust the time base control in the clockwise direction. Here's a different oscilloscope. Let's remind ourselves of the controls. Here's the X shift, moving the whole trace left or right. Here's the Y shift, moving the whole trace up and down. Here's the volts per division, or Y gain control. That affects the height of the trace. And here's the time base. And this one also has a variable time base on it. This is the AC-DC switch. If you're using your oscilloscope with a circuit with a battery in it, make sure it's in DC. This is a twin beam oscilloscope. It can show two traces at once. It has separate inputs for each trace, separate volts per division controls for each trace, and separate Y shift controls for each trace.